My name is Rio Grange and I'm 28 years old and I actually live in Haley, Idaho. So, small town. I am a wife and a mother and a recent boss, you could say. I did start my own business and it's been really, really fun to balance all of those, but I love it. Something that just fills me with such joy, so it feels like I won something, is when I'm able to make my kids laugh, especially when the days are busy with work, when my husband and I are both working and distracted. If I'm just able to hear their laughter, it warms my heart. And then I think in a business sense too, being able to provide certain materials and products that just really can uplift someone and change their outlook or perspective and help them to engage in what they love. It's so rewarding. And as far as how I just kind of celebrate them, honestly, I think I let myself unplug and kind of give myself some me time. Oftentimes that's in the outdoors, so I'll get to just spend some time with my family and my husband and unplug and leave work at work and the stresses of home there, and we just go escape together. Failures are, I feel like they happen often, all the time, small and big, but I think one that continues to happen that makes me feel like I failed is when I just feel I'm spread so thin and I can't give all my relationships the time and attention that I want. But what I have learned is that in the moments that I am spending with those people I love, to make the absolute most of it and to give myself grace and know that I'm doing the absolute best I can and giving my time to what I love most, and I can't fault myself for that. But when there's really big like mistakes on my part with my business, those have happened and they're so painful. But something that I have learned is to find a sounding board. Oftentimes it's my husband or my mom or just a really good friend, and it helps so much to talk through them. And oftentimes you find that there's learning in those failures, and a day, a week, a month will go by and it already seems so small, and you've learned from it and you'll do better the next time. Biggest accomplishment, something that we're like in the midst of right now that feels so exciting but scary all at the same time. My husband and I are both pursuing our dreams, and that feels so good and scary at the same time, but it has been so fun to see each other just blossom as we follow these passions. And we do so both at home with our kids, and so it has hard days, but in the end, it feels, we can be so proud that we know that we are following what we absolutely love to do most and that we can see each other do that. It's also really cool to have my children see what it looks like to follow a dream and what can come from that. And I love that we can just all take the risk together and enjoy it one step at a time. Man, when I think of celebrating other women and their victories, I constantly have to remind myself there is room for everyone to succeed and there is room for everyone to feel beautiful. Like, there's, just because a woman walks in and you think that she's gorgeous doesn't immediately mean that you are not. And there's obviously that we have this potential we were given, and there's room for every one of us to reach that and to feel absolutely beautiful and absolutely capable of what we came here to do.